Alright guys, I got them here with a little bit of a project share, and this one is for the lovely Nicole Rodriguez. So Nicole, if you don't want to see this love, please click off. I love you, and I want it to be a surprise if you want it to be. So Brittany made this tassel, and I just added it on the side because I thought it fit very well. This book actually lights up the windows. So, I thought that was so cool. I left the sticker on there, that way she knew to push it. And she can take that sticker off once she knows that it lights up. Brittany also painted these wood veneers. So, she painted 5 of them. So, I'm putting one on each one of my journals. That way you guys have something from her too. Put some beautiful lace and some beautiful trim. Some corners. I made these flowers. Thought they were very pretty. And the back is just, this is fabric, you guys. So I thought it was very pretty. We got some different fabric to do the Halloween journals with. And the side is just the signature. This is, I used a scarf and I cut it and just tied it. I put it in there with the eyelets though. Oh yeah, there's some of that like netting on the back there. I thought it was very pretty. So this has got lots of layers to it, but I love that it lights up. That is so cool. So let's get inside because I am running short on time on my video or my camera. That's my phone. I gotta upload videos tonight. So I pretty much just used the paper stack from last year from Hobby Lobby. It was Halloween something, I can't remember. But I just got some tags in here for some journaling cards, and then this is just a piece of the paper. And I just Halloween dyed some paper, me and Brittany did. I've tore all the pages to make it look like old and grungy, which it turned out really good. These bags that I always put in all of my journals. I've been using cards in the Halloween ones because I got a bunch of them super cheap. So this one just says, Happy Halloween from someone who thinks you're special. I love that. And then this is just a glassine bag that she can put something in. I just made that with the wax paper that I put on the bottom. So I just made it out of that. So I thought that was cool. Tore the paper again. So cool. I just put a back clip on here. And I left this kind of blank because I've done so much like stamping and dyeing of the paper and just a lot. So you'll see that it's kind of blank for journaling. So stamping there. But I did add some stuff, but it got super thick, so I couldn't add a whole lot more. Here's a tuck spot with an inventory tag. And I just tore all of the edges. This is an old Sears catalog. We dyed that. Writing paper. The rest of that envelope. I put a little bit of fabric that I had left on here and just put a puffy sticker, and I thought it was cute and added a good piece to it. Coffee filter. Happy pumpkin day. How cute is that, right? And then here's the middle of the signature, and I do have charms on there. You guys know that I like to add charms on those. And then I used my Copics to color the pumpkin, and I'm getting better at coloring. I'm excited about that. There is the rest of that coffee filter, and this is just a paper. This is a piece of paper that got ripped, and I didn't like the way it was ripped in the project that I was using it for, so I put it in here. I thought it added a good look to it, so I hope she likes this. And then this has a Jack and Femur piece that she can use in there. It's a patch. I thought that was cool. Some more of that Sears. And this is a digital print. And you can put something in there. I gotta put a tag or something in there. I forgot it was there, actually. Thought I filled it. I will fill it. Some more coffee dyed paper. I stamped the corners on those with corner punch. There's another pumpkin that I colored. Here's a Halloween dyed bag. Ledger paper. And there's the rest of that card, and it says, "In hope you never forget it." So it'd be cool for her to find that. And she'll be like, "What is that from?" And she'll look back at the card. So it's kind of cool. And then this is a bag, and inside I've got tags in there. some more of that paper. And look, I colored this too. It says, boo, from me to you. How cute is that? I love that stamp. And then this is just a bag, and it's got a tag in it. This is the second signature, guys. And then just some ephemera, some of that bat paper, and then this has got tags in it. Some music note paper that is Halloween dyed, and this is not showing up as good as the Halloween dyed looks, but it's orange and purple, very pretty. And this is another card. I like to use these in here. And there's a pocket that I made with a glassine bag, or with that wax paper, and I just put tags in it. Coffee filter, paper, some more coffee dye paper. This is a part of an orange envelope. And then that's just some stamping that I've done. This is an envelope, and I ripped the corner of it just because I thought it was so cool. So I don't know. She can do what she wants to do with it. I just thought it added a good look to it. And then that's coffee filter. And then this is a pocket, and I added some tags in there for her. And then it says, be careful, beware, Halloween is in the air. I thought that was cute. Some music note paper. And then the coffee, or the Halloween dye paper at the end. And then this is a library card, and I always handmade in Ohio, and then I'll sign it. And I just put a flower with a book of spells. So I love the way this book came out. I think it is absolutely adorable. So I have a couple more books to do, but I will have them done tomorrow and Thursday. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. So until my next video, I hope you enjoy this, Nicole. And I love swapping with you, and I can't wait until our next one. Bye, guys.